You may need a spare charger for that Apple Watch. I'm Bridget Carey, and this is your CNET Update. Folks, we need to talk about the Apple Watch. I have some news that may be hard to hear, it may even be hard to believe, but Apple's first smartwatch is not going to be perfect. I know everyone's salivating over the coming Apple Watch and all its gold trim glory, but there's the possibility it could be plagued with the same problem of most smartwatches, and that's battery life. Although Apple has yet to reveal full battery life information about the watch, sources told the news site 9to5Mac that the battery life is falling short of Apple's goal to have it work for 19 hours of mixed active and passive use. But how much shorter is unknown. The report says it may just last 2.5 hours with heavy app use. That's like if you can't stop checking apps. And 4 hours for exercise tracking. We won't know for sure until we put it through battery tests when it comes out in the spring. And I'm sure it won't be long before we start getting battery pack cuff accessories. No, seriously, there are battery charger wristbands right now on Kickstarter. In other mobile news, U.S. carrier T-Mobile is stirring things up again. This time it involves your credit score. When you see a commercial for a discounted or a free smartphone, whether it's T-Mobile or another carrier, you can only get that deal when you have a well-qualifying credit score. It's all in that itty-bitty print on those commercials. Well, T-Mobile says more than half of Americans don't have a credit score that's good enough to get the deals. And those folks have to pay more upfront and over time or go prepaid. But let's say you didn't have good credit, but you still signed up for T-Mobile. Well, if you paid your bills on time for a year, you get upgraded and you can qualify for all the best offers without a credit check, like a loyalty thank you of sorts. T-Mobile is the fourth place carrier, but with all these recent wild promotions like data rollover, it's gaining customers and it's on the path to passing Sprint. T-Mobile is growing so fast that on Friday, Sprint began targeting T-Mobile. Sprint has a new promotion that promises to pay T-Mobile customers $200 for a smartphone trade-in, plus up to $350 to cover switching costs. In other news, car makers are paving the way for more high-tech cars. Ford just opened a research lab in Silicon Valley with a focus on improving car internet connections and self-driving vehicles. But before we get to those self-driving cars, other car makers are focusing on getting us to buy electric vehicles. BMW and Volkswagen partnered with the company ChargePoint to build out at least 100 more charging stations along the East and West Coast, which can get a car to 80% power in less than 30 minutes. That's your tech news update. There's always more at CNET.com. From our studios in New York, I'm Bridget Carey.